774.
We're looking at what their head movement is, the head excursion, the head position relative to the torso, heart rate, their skin temperature, and then we track those throughout the drive to see how they change. With the advent of self-driving vehicles, we anticipate that as drivers transform to passengers, there'll be an increased incidence of motion sickness response. The automakers are recognizing that this is going to be a problem for them in their self-driving vehicles, but there's not a clear solution as to how to address it. This study was very much focused on developing this testbed, a reliable way to quantify motion sickness. We looked at driving data sets that are existing here at TRI, at the Transportation Research Institute. The frequency that people would do different maneuvers, braking events, turning events within their normal commuting drive. And then we use that data to inform the route that we developed on M-City. Each participant comes in twice. The first time they are a normal passenger, they're able to experience the ride as they would choose to do so. A second time we ask them to engage off of a handheld device. We've created a task and it's meant to be really normal experiences of what you would complete on your handheld device. The intention here is to quantify, are they engaged with the material that they're reading? So we're actually recording the time that they spend on a page, whether they're giving an accurate response all throughout these tasks, to understand as they're increasing their engagement within the tasks, does that affect how they respond with motion sickness.
What's your rating on a scale of 1 to 10?
2.
One of the most important parts, I think, is this self-report, allowing them to provide their own responses and then correlating those responses to their physiological measures as well to see if we can quantify in an objective way how people feel. What are the precursors to nausea? How does it manifest throughout the drive? And can we quantify that robustly from one person to the next? And then we can start getting into those mitigation countermeasures. I mean, that's just going to be fun to understand what it is that we can do to address those issues. We need to be at that level of, I feel great. I can sit here and choose to do whatever activity or behavior I want to do in the vehicle.